I know that this might seem like an overly ambitious and aspirational goal, but it is my heart that we would be the generation that ends factory farming forever, that there would be no more factory farms. Yeah, that's an overly ambitious and aspirational goal. It seems like in our day and age, this is an impossible task to actually accomplish, but this is a feat I dream of. This is a dream of mine. I don't know how to live in a world where animals are abused, where there's factory farming. I don't know how to live in a world of factory farming. I want to end factory farming. All I know to do, like to have mental health in this area, is to fight for animals, to be a passionate and zealous animal advocate. Like when you see in factory farms, mothers having their calves stolen from them, and then they're crying for days. They're crying for days because their baby was taken from them. Or you look at animals that are in such tight confined spaces. Some of them are never allowed to see the outdoors for their entire life. Like they were made for the outdoors. They're never allowed to see the outdoors for their entire life. And they live in these tight confined, horribly confined prison spaces. And the only time they're allowed to see the outdoors is when they're on a terrifying truck ride on the back of a truck to die in a slaughterhouse, right? Like this is tragic. This is a travesty of justice. Or you look at chickens that are de-beaked, like the way that we use our hands to explore the world, they have their beaks taken off of their faces so that you can squeeze more chickens in. It's tragic. So what are we gonna do about it? There's a couple things. I'm not being sponsored by any of these organizations. This is just coming from an impetus and an unction in the pneuma realm for me. I believe by the grace of the absolute hope, like I can be somebody and you can be somebody who fights for animals and saves animals. There's a couple organizations. Again, I'm not being sponsored by them. This is just something I want to do on my own. But number one, the Humane League fights for animal rights. So you can actually join in on the animal advocacy by donating to the Humane League or visiting, for example, Gentle Barn or donating to the Gentle Barn. The Gentle Barn is a beautiful place. I did a vlog there once. It is so beautiful and it's a wonderful place to donate to. They've saved thousands of animals over the years. Like you can rub a pig's belly. Pigs love belly rubs. You can hug a cow. You can cuddle a turkey. You can like look into the eyes of these animals and know that they deserve at least every bit as rights as we do. I think they're better than us. I think they deserve more rights. But we live in a world that doesn't teach this message. In fact, this might seem crazy, right? This might seem insane. And that's what's so tragic to me is it logically makes no sense. It's a logical fallacy to assume that pigs, for example, which are smarter than dogs and cats, like cats have the intelligence of toddlers, like that we don't treat them the way that they deserve. Like I was seeing some comments when I was fighting for pigs. It's like, well, they taste like bacon, so they're yummy to eat. It's like, so humans taste like bacon, apparently, from what I've studied. Like, it's a tragic thing. So what do we do? Rather than being angry and bitter, I don't think that's necessarily going to solve the problem unless that's your calling, like if that can get something done in legislation. I want to be somebody who galvanizes and invites you into this beautiful journey of rescuing and saving animals. So you can donate to the Gentle Barn, which saves thousands of animals, gives them acupuncture. It just treats them like the kings and queens that these animals deserve, or the Humane League to help end factory farming. But also like how you treat the animals in your own life is so, so essential. So one of the things that I love to do is make sure that Fridge is treated like royalty, my cat Fridge. So I brush his teeth every day. I brush his hair twice a day, clean his face twice a day. Like I clean his ears every day. Like I just want to make sure I'm playing with him and he's getting his exercise and like, you know, he gets a certain amount of healthy dental treats and then making sure he always has the best food and the finest water, not even tap water, but like instead like the really nice reverse osmosis water. Like there's things that we can do to treat animals the way that they deserve to be treated. So I just want to invite you on this journey with me. Like I didn't always have my eyes open to this stuff. So wherever you're at in your journey, like I didn't always see things this way and now I do. And like, I want to invite you into this journey to treat animals like royalty. And maybe we can become the generation before our time is up here that ends factory farming forever.